ISD. We're here at Danielson Middle School. This has been an incredibly tough week for everybody, and we know and understand from a personal perspective some of the challenges that many of us are facing with damage in our homes, with no running water, with on and off electricity through this whole week. And that's very traumatic, and we understand that. And so we're going to work hard to provide as much flexibility as possible as we go forward into this week to make sure that your needs are met. We understand that you're trying to survive at this point in time, and that you're trying to make sure that your families are taken care of. We want to support you in any way that we can. So many things are happening right now as we recover from this week of winter storms. Our maintenance crews are out and about checking buildings, making sure that any leaks and any damage that's been done during the winter storm is addressed and mitigated as best we can. We have our child nutrition services in every facility trying to make sure that we have the ability to serve food to kids next week. Teaching and learning continues to monitor the situation and provide flexibility and preparation and resources for our teachers and make sure that our students' needs are met.
Our communities are facing trauma on top of already trauma. We've worked through what school looks like in COVID situation, and now we're getting ready to face the next hurdle, which is what do you do after a winter storm has knocked out not only power but water. Every household might have a different story, might have a different way they've dealt with it. It might have been they lost water, they lost power. It might have been family members were losing water and power and they were trying to reach out and help them. Or they may have been helping out their community. Everybody's got a bit of a different story, I think, but it's all been traumatic as we're trying to figure out how to pull together and move forward. So I know we're in for a long haul, but we've got two meetings this week. We're going to be talking about the waivers that we need to approve, anything from attendance to how we're going to be getting people out here to start repairing our buildings. Some of our buildings have had flood damages, and I know the district's still out there doing assessments. The board is here to support getting learning in place, supporting our teachers, supporting our community, and of course our district, our campuses. Board members are here. They're part of the community, and we are all seeing different parts of the community responding to the various community needs, and that's awesome. Such an honor to be on a board who's out there being engaged, helping community in various ways. I'm seeing administration come out, the city's coming out, some of the water stations that are available for our community. Everybody's just trying to pull together to help our community. It's about us moving through this together.
I just want to express our sincere gratitude to Hill Country Community Ministries and to Danielson Middle School for coordinating this effort to get some needed supplies out to our community. As you can see, they're flowing through the line. This is what we're about in Leander ISD. We're about community, about being better together. We want you to know that we are doing everything in our power to be ready to accept children. We understand that our teachers and our parents and our families are under a lot of stress, and we want to make sure that we help meet your needs. As we come out of this very challenging week, we're doing everything in our power to make sure that your children's learning needs are met as we come back into this new normal. Please remember that COVID is still out there and we need to practice our protocols and make sure that we keep each other safe. Together we can do this. We are one LISD.